Hi guys, thanks for tuning in. This is Mike Lucas at Instagram, Lucas_47days on the bank. Today I've decided to do a video just on a quick ledger rig for pike fishing. It's an extremely effective rig and very quick to put together. Just take you through the equipment I've got. So firstly, I've got my treble hooks, which is my Westlake size 2 treble hooks. I've then got my Fox Range Predator ledger set up. You actually get two setups in here, so the actual ledger itself and the buffer bead. I've then got my Savage Gear swivel hook, just to give you a closer view on this one. As you can see, I've used this in previous videos with my floating, and then I've got a weight as well. The weight depends on the flow of the river. I would suggest probably bringing a few weights with you just to make sure that the ledger stays at the bottom of the river or lake or wherever you might be fishing. To start this rig off, obviously I've got my braided line on first. First thing you do is get your ledger and actually stick the line straight through the large ledger rig hoop, and then go straight into the buffer bead. Now, unfortunately, sometimes with these braided lines, it's quite difficult to get it through, but as you can see, it's now gone through. The next part then is my swivel head. So my quick release swivel, straight onto the line. Again, depending on which knot you use, I use a simple 5 twist knot, or 5 straight back through. Sometimes I'll wet the line again, depending on the braid. That knot's quite secure. Then after this, the next thing I do is I add my trebles, which I should have unpacked prior to this video, but I haven't. Quickly undo these, sorry about this. Okay, that's my trebles unhooked. I did say that I'm using size 2 hooks, probably because I'm gonna use mackerel as my bait, or a mackerel's tail. I generally find size 2s quite good. This then simply hooks straight on to my snap-off rig. I then cut my line slightly, tidy up my rig. I then pull the buffer bead straight down over the actual swivel itself. Again, just tidying this up, as you can see. And lastly, I just clip on my weight onto the rig itself. Again, as I said in the video, it depends on the rivers you're fishing, what weight you would like to use. And you can see now it's a nice, simple running rig. So initially it will lay on the ground, the pike will pick it up, pick up the dead bait, the rig will run along, set the alarm off, and you'll be able to then strike into the pike nice and early.
Okay, I'll quickly give you a last glimpse at the ledger rig that I've set up. So to start off with, I've got the ledger, the rig itself with the weight on, then I've got the buffer bead, the swivel, then down onto my trace with my two trebles.
Okay guys, for the last part of the video, I'm going to show you how I put my dead bait on the line. Pretty simple. Unfortunately, I've got to use a sardine today because I don't have any mackerel in the freezer. Anyways, the trebles and the sardine, it's quite a small sardine. Nevertheless, it will do for the video. I then look for where the treble hook is barbed. So you use the barbed end and I just put it in just behind the tail so it's got good strength, as you can see, to be able to cast. Granted, you wouldn't cast very far with a sardine. However, being frozen definitely helps. And the next treble then I just put behind the head of the sardine. So just behind the eye. Again, it's usually just a little bit of a harder part. As you can see, this is nice and safely secure into the fish. Could go a little bit deeper with that first hook if need be. Straighten up the line so that when it's laying on the floor, it's nice and straight. And obviously, this is how I would set up the same way with a mackerel. Probably the mackerel will be slightly larger, so I'd be able to go into the back of the mackerel rather than just above the eye. I just wanted to add an actual bit of a bonus feature. One of the very simple setups of this ledger rig is I've literally just changed my trace to a single hook trace. And what I'm going to use now is what's called the kebab rig. I've just used that sardine I used in the previous video. All I've done, I've purchased the kebab rig setup, so it's the pop-up at the bottom with almost like a straight red steak straight through the middle. And all I do is chop up my sardine, I put the heavier on bigger ends at the bottom, and then what I've done is I've cut it into four or five pieces. Now, this is a very easy and very effective method, but very underused. I then hook the barbed end of the hooks into the top of the rig and then simply put on one of the caps, as you can see, and this will keep it on there. Now, when this is in the water, it should pop up and stand like this. It's quite tempting for the pike to take it, and I've had many catches on this rig as well. So it's very underused, and if you're struggling on it, on a particular lake or river and you don't seem to be catching, I would suggest possibly giving this a try. It could be the difference of blanking and actually catching yourself a decent sized pike. Obviously, you could catch any size pike, but I would definitely suggest giving this one a go. Lastly, I'd like to just thank you for tuning in. If you like my content, feel free to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Hopefully I'm gonna produce a bit more videos, hints and tips. And if you wanted to check out a couple of fish that I've caught, if you head over to my Instagram page, which is lucas47_daysonthebank. Thank you.